Duerden's back with me this morning from Magmatic Resources. Peter, good morning.
Morning, Andrew.
You've had some news this... Yeah, good to have you back, Peter. You've had some news this week here on the Wellington North Project. Diamond drilling set to kick off next week. What's the latest here?
Yeah, Andrew, that's right. Yeah, so we've got all our permitting and access in place now. So we're mobilising equipment up to the old Bodangora Gold Field, a high-grade gold field that produced over 230,000 ounces back in the day, one of the earliest sites of gold production in Australia. And so, yeah, we're excited to be drilling underneath some old mines. And we've also got a ground mag crew that are operating there at the moment.
Remind us, you're close to Alkane's Boda discovery here too, aren't you?
Yeah, exactly, in that part of the world. So really exciting discovery a couple of years ago in that part of the world. We're in the same belt of rocks as Cadia, Newcrest Cadia operation, you know, the largest gold producer in Australia. And so, yeah, it's a real hot bit of ground. And we're literally about 3 kilometres south from Boda, very strategic bit of ground, and drilling underneath some high-grade historic mines.
Well, give us a bit more detail, Peter, as to the program itself, what you'll be testing here.
Yeah, so we'll be drilling, you know, basically extensional positions underneath the old mine workings, areas that we know were mined, reported high gold grades. And we'll be using the ground mag data as well, just to refine where we're drilling those positions. But we're fairly confident we'll see some pretty exciting grades, and based on some of the historic reports.
How deep will you be drilling here?
Well, yeah, the mining only extended 100 to 250 metres vertical depth. So really, they're modest holes. They're shallow diamond holes that we'll be doing. We'll be collecting structural information, which will help guide follow-up drilling as well, getting a really good look at the core. And so very modest, shallow drilling. But we're guessing it'll be about 2,000 metre program at this stage.
How long do you reckon that'll take you?
We'll be active over probably 6 weeks, all going well. We'll be looking to, you know, we've got enough permitting in place to be able to keep going beyond that as well.
And you say you're sourcing an additional air core rig here, are you?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, we'll bring an air core rig in as a second rig to be able to test stepping a little bit further away from the mine workings. The diamond core drilling will really focus immediately beneath, down dip, down plunge from the old workings, and the air core rig will just help to map in front of us. Yep.
And just for those not familiar, Peter, this ground mag survey, what will that assist you with?
Yeah, well, that's a high resolution survey. It'll give us some geophysical data, which helps to map out the rocks and can often help track the lodes themselves, the gold lodes. So we'll be looking for other high grade gold targets based on that data, and also just tracking the lodes where we know they've been mined historically.
Realistically, when do you reckon you might start to see some results coming in?
Yeah, we'll be processing the core as it's coming out of the ground on site, and we'll be prioritising assaying where we can. A few weeks away, we'll be starting to, you know, expecting a flow of news flow.
And how are your confidence levels leading up to the start of the program?
Look, I think, you know, it's something that needs to be done. This area has received very little modern exploration. We'd earlier in the year and during COVID, we'd spent a lot of time modelling up the old historic mine workings. And so that's given us a bit of confidence that we know where things are sitting in 3D, and we can drill some pretty sensible holes based on that data set.
Good to get an update from you. Peter, thanks very much.
Thanks a lot, Andrew. Good to see you.